Welcome to Thorlabs. My name is Bill, and today I'd like to talk about some things that I consider when mounting my Optomech. For today's demonstration, I have some bases, some post holders, some posts, and some optic and laser mounts. Let's begin with our base. The base has two primary sides. One is relatively flat, and the other has some material that's been removed from the middle. This material that's been removed is called a relief cut, and the purpose is to minimize the amount of material that's in contact with our mounting surface. This prevents any irregularities that occur on the surface of our base from mounting that base flat against our mounting surface. So if you ever have a choice as to which side of the base to mount down, I always try to remember to take the relief cut and point that down toward my table. Now this particular base has two mounting slots for us to secure the base to the table with screws. Whenever there is a mounting slot, I always try to remember to use a washer. Let's see why. So on one side, I'm going to just attach a screw. And on the other side, I'm going to add a washer with the curved shiny side of the washer against my anodized base. Now you can see that the width of the slot is relatively small with respect to the diameter of the head of the screw. This compares to the diameter of the washer that extends across the entire width of the slot. Now, if I happen to be a person that likes to over-tighten my Optomech, I can take my hex key, and with the side without the washer, I can tighten this down. And when I come back, I can see that I've permanently deformed the edges of the slot. I've exposed the metal underneath my anodized surface. So now I've created a hole in the sides of that slot. And if I want to make some small tweaks and mount that base relatively close to where I had mounted it previously, the head of the screw is going to want to fall into that hole. And that creates a lot of headaches when you're doing small tweaks. Alternatively, I could take the side with the washer and really tighten that down. And so when I loosen, we can see that the anodized surface is still pristine, and I have not exposed the inner metal of the slot. So if you want to increase the lifetime of your base, please always try to remember to use washers with your screws. So now let's take a look at our posts. Now our posts have tapped holes on both sides. On one side, we have a relatively large tapped hole. And on the opposite side, we have a relatively small tapped hole. On the side with a small tapped hole, we typically include a set screw that comes pre-installed. This way, if you have a piece of Optomech that has the same size tapped hole, then you can simply thread that post directly into your piece of Optomech. Now you notice that there is a through hole in the middle of the post. And the purpose of this through hole is to be able to put a ball driver through that hole and provide a little bit more torque to snug up that connection. Now you want to be a little careful when you grab your Optomech. If you happen to have a mount that has a spring in it and you extend that spring, you can overextend it and damage that spring. Alternatively, it's possible that if you pull the front plate away from that back plate, that you can lose the ball that the front plate pivots about. And this ball is very small and can easily fall into the table. Now, if you happen to have a piece of Optomech that has a through hole, then you'll want to use a cap screw to attach it to your post. So in this case, I've already removed the set screw from the top of the post. I'll grab a cap screw, put that into my mount, and use a ball driver to attach the optic mount to my post. Here again, if I like, I can use the torque hole and really snug up that connection. Now, the post also has a relatively large tapped hole in the bottom. This matches the tapped holes in your table, so if you wanted, you could thread your post directly into your table. I personally don't do that very often, but where I do use this tapped hole a lot is when I'm using large pieces of Optomech. So, for example, this laser mount also has the same tapped hole size. And so here, I would use a set screw and thread my post onto my laser mount. And if I want to use the torque hole, I can snug that up. Now let's take a look at our post holders. The post holder has a tapped hole in the bottom as well. And here again, we can now take this post holder and mount it directly into our table. Now, one disadvantage of using the set screw is that the knob is going to stop in a random location. You're not going to have control over where you put that knob. You can try to put shims underneath the post holder and have it stop in the position that you want, but it's usually not going to work out too well. So if you need the knob in a specific location, then I typically end up using a base. So if we have this base, which has a through hole, and our post holder that has our tapped hole, so we'll use a small cap screw to attach the base to our post holder. Now, I want to make sure that I use a small screw. I don't want the threads of the screw to poke up into the post holder, because then it's possible for that tapped hole in the bottom of the post to thread onto that screw. Now, the height of your Optomech is going to be dependent on the height of your post holder and the length of your post. I like to keep my beam height relatively close to the table. That maximizes the stability of my setup. If for some reason I need to bring my beam height away from the table, I'm not going to take a long post and put it into a tiny post holder. This increases the length of the lever arm and decreases the length of the two-point contact inside of our post holder. If I need to bring my beam height up, I'm going to use a post holder that gets me most of the way there. That maximizes the amount of adjustment range that I have, decreases the lever arm, and increases the length of the two-point contact between the post holder and the post, increasing the stability of my setup. Now, one thing to point out is that having a single point of contact leaves you open to rotation. So that's okay with small pieces of Optomech like this. It's going to take something relatively specific to really loosen this piece of Optomech on top of your post. But if I'm using a large piece of Optomech that has cables running out the end going to my driver, it's possible somebody could accidentally reach across the table, pull those cables, or hit the side of the bulky piece of Optomech. So in this case, I like to use two points of contact to increase the stability of the mount. So in this case, I'll take my other post and I'll thread that onto my laser mount. I'll take my second post holder and here you can see it becomes important to ensure my knob is in a specific location so that I can access both of them. And now I can take my laser mount, put it inside of my post holders, and I'm going to have a very stable setup. I'm not going to be able to rotate this laser mount with respect to my base. Hopefully this helps you out in the lab someday. And if you have any questions, feel free to contact TechSupport.